This is a story about soil and the cycle of life and death and decay that creates new soil, which helps produce new life. Let's start our story in this Durham backyard. Natalie Ross and John Jack are building flower beds with compost. That's decayed organic matter that's been added to soil. About 10 months ago, the compost that garden gnome is sitting on looked like this. Everything in the bucket can be composted.
We have some rice here. We have a nice tea bag.
Okay.
And the string, it will decompose as well. A nice little paper towel will break right down. The microbes will love it. Coffee grounds. Yeah, I can't believe how many coffee grounds get sent to the landfill. If it came from life, then you can compost it.
Think of compost as nature's way of turning waste back into nourishment for plants.
I compost because I can't stand the thought of sending these precious nutrients into a landfill where they're going to create methane gas that contributes to global climate change.
But once that's in the landfill, it's so densely compacted that it doesn't decompose properly. What you get out of that is methane gas, which is a major problem in landfills because it has 5 times the greenhouse effect of carbon dioxide.
The Raleigh-based company Compost Now is opening offices across the state, providing a compost pickup service. The United States Environmental Protection Agency estimates that about 30% of household waste is organic and can be composted.
We're here to sort of intercept these food scraps from going to the landfill where they truly become waste there and redirect them into valuable resources.
Compost Now delivers the compost it collects here. This is Brooks Contractor in Goldston. It produces almost 40,000 tons of composted soil per year.
Compost is by far the quickest, safest way to get organic matter into the soil. And organic matter is the key to all of these soil processes that actually create soil.
The composted soil is moist, dark, and crumbly when it's ready to ship out.
This is excellent compost. You see these little brown flecks in it? Those are eggshells. So that provides a lime source, a continuous slow-release lime source for the plant. There's tons of microbiology and life in this handful of compost, so this is very much alive.
But the raw materials that make up compost are anything but attractive. Besides what Compost Now delivers, the company collects food waste and scraps from more than 150 restaurants and school cafeterias. It also collects hay, manure, and feed from the state fairgrounds and used cooking oil.
This is nitrogen, the food waste is nitrogen, and all the bulk of materials are carbon.
It's all mixed together and then spread out into long windrows. Giant machines turn the mix because the microorganisms that break down the organic waste and create the nutrient-rich soil require air and water to do their work. Temperatures inside those piles can reach 120 degrees, which is hot enough to break down even bone. The whole process takes about 10 months.
Essentially, a handful of compost is a handful of life. And that's what our soil system and water system right now is severely lacking. We'll work with a lot of universities that are interested in using compost for their crop inputs, using compost for bioremediation of contaminated soils.
The sky's the limit. In fact, if we were to take a carrot right in here, this is an Imperator carrot. This is your Bugs Bunny special.
Colin Whitley is a soil scientist who says the compost from Brooks Contractor is what makes his garden grow.
The conditions were right. The pH was right. The friability of the soil was right. It had been amended, so everything was working. And that's the proof right there.
Whitley manages the Goodwill Community Foundation's community farm. He also teaches gardening skills and crop and soil science to the volunteers that work the 3-acre plot. The garden's bounty is donated to area food banks. The farm sits at the edge of Research Triangle Park. The soil is white stone clay, which is tightly compacted and doesn't hold water.
Reading the soil report, here we have a pH of 4.3. That's terribly, terribly acidic. And we have a cation exchange capacity of 6.7.
The cation exchange measures the soil's ability to absorb nutrients. A low number isn't good. All told, the report shows this soil is terrible for growing anything.
These bigger ones.
Whitley credits soil science with making his clay-heavy, soil-poor garden so incredibly green. He brought in dozens of truckloads of compost and continually tests the soil, adding lime and other minerals.
To have good shoots, you have to have good roots. To have good roots, you have to have good soil. In order to have good soil, you have to do certain things. You have to know what the pH requirement is. You have to add friable material, compost. And then the compost does your fertilizing for you and keeps everything fluffy.
They are soil qualities that Natalie and John are hoping to create in their backyard so they can grow vegetables and in turn create more compost, which makes the soil cycle complete.